Saying to you earlier, we have a lot to talk about, and very important stuff. How have you been?
I've been good, Bianca. How have you been?
I'm okay, you know, Chris. I'm hanging in there. I can't believe it's March already. But most importantly for me, I know when the viewers at home, they're thinking, why are we seated? What we have to talk about?
Yeah.
And I know Brave is what's brought me here today. What does Brave stand for?
So Brave is something that I created in my head a couple of years ago, and it manifested itself last year in October. And it's a platform that I want to use to connect, inspire, and empower young women in our society. And that includes us creating events or opportunities that will help them develop soft skills, and also help them, inspire them to do more, want to achieve more for themselves.
Mm-hmm. What was it like growing up? Where did you grow up?
Okay, I actually grew up in Tema. I'm a Tema girl. And growing up, I grew up with five aunties, and they've always been role models for me. And I wouldn't say I come from a privileged background, but knowing that hard work, independence, and working towards your goals were those important pillars that all my aunties and my mom taught me. So it's something that has always come easy to me. So, yeah.
The reason why I ask is because it's always important to know where your mind is at that triggered you to even decide to help other girls.
Mm-hmm.
There must be experiences that you've seen or been in your environment that makes you feel like, I've got to help these other young ladies. But I'm happy that you've begun the journey.
Yeah.
And that's what we're going to delve into at this point.
Yes.
I mean, we were talking on the phone a few days ago, and I was amazed.
Yeah.
I'm also shocked that the numbers for ending period poverty are quite crazy, I must say. What I found more shocking was that it's a luxury item, sanitary towels, on this side of town, which is something we all take for granted.
Mm-hmm.
Why did Brave want to connect with ending period poverty by 2025?
So I think the end period poverty came about with actually a midwife who attended one of our events last year. And she told us about this community she's been working with for the past year. And it was a community in Pampram called Minya. It's a very small community. And she told us that, oh, there's rampant cases of teenage pregnancy, and that's a result of the fact that the girls do not have access to sanitary pads because they have to sleep with the guys in the neighborhood to be able to get as little as 5 cedis to be able to afford a sanitary pad. And I was like, I mean, this cannot be, because this is just 2 hours away from Accra, you know? And so just imagine if you would have to go even further from Accra. Like, we're in 2021, for God's sake. And still sanitary pads are something that we consider a basic necessity. It's actually a luxury for someone to be able to afford that. So I think that's how the whole project came about. And we got in touch with a sanitary brand. We did our research. We were trying to look for a brand that will work together with us long term, and where the conversation wouldn't be as complicated, because it was something that, an initiative that I wanted us to just get going. I didn't want to wait 3 months down the line, still be in conversation of who to partner with. And thankfully, Sincerely came on board. And so that's how we've partnered with them for the next couple of months to be able to afford and provide the sanitary pads to the girls in Pram Pram.
For me, it's also people who are watching who want to know where they can access the numbers.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, you mentioned it now, but like, I did my research and I was really so saddened by the numbers and the figures when it comes to period poverty. Elaborate.
There's a 20% import tax on sanitary pad products, which is very wrong, because then the GRA is trying to tell us that it's a luxury to menstruate, which is not supposed to be, because you menstruate for it's something that naturally occurs, so it shouldn't be a luxury for you to menstruate. And last year, a study came out from researchers from KNUSD, and they mentioned that about 40% of girls in the rural areas reported being absent from school because they did not have access to sanitary pads or sanitary hygiene related problems, which I think it's something that also shouldn't be the case. Girls between the ages of 14 to 16 are actually much more vulnerable to poor menstrual hygiene practices because they don't have, due to lack of access to sanitary pads. So that's the age where we have to try and educate them and make sure that they're getting it right, and also making sure that they have access to the sanitary pad products, because obviously these lack of, if you have bad sanitary menstrual hygiene practices, you tend to have infections that can cause bad sexual reproductive health issues as well.
Mm-hmm. It's so funny how it graduates into something way mm-hmm. more than expected. So you mm-hmm. find, like you're saying, mm-hmm. at the end, you report issues even conceiving, which yep. isn't a conversation to have at 9.
Exactly.
It's a conversation when you're in your 20s.
20s, 30s, exactly.
Another thing I found is when they don't have access to the basic mm-hmm. classes, they can't turn up to school. And yep. it can sometimes go as long as, when I've read online,
exactly.
6 months, because mm-hmm. it's like, it stops.
Exactly. So that means like every month of the year, the girl has to be out of school for at least 5 to 7 days. So that's school missed, that's work, education missed, that could actually propel the girl to higher heights if she was able to have access to sanitary pads throughout the year, you know? And that's obviously also a step back, you know? And we're all about having girls in school throughout the year, having girls, empowering girls as well. So if we are having this conversation, then obviously that has to include making sure that the girls have the access to everything that they need in order to be able to go to school and concentrate on school.
The purpose to break, mm-hmm. I mean, we've now gone into statistics, we talked about the figures and exactly what you stand for, mm-hmm. But how is break bridging the gap? You know, what are the activities you have coming up? I know you started from last year, but what should people look forward to? Mm-hmm. And how can they also engage in some of the activities?
So our plan for the year is to have monthly masterclasses. So the masterclass, we invite industry leaders. So it doesn't matter which sector, can be entertainment, military, agriculture, everything. And initially we were going to have it as a standalone program, but now we've decided to take it on tour. So we're going to go campus to campus, and obviously the subject that we'll cover for the month will cater to the campus that we are visiting. So for instance, for March masterclass, we have Majid in the entertainment. So we are looking to go to NAFTI so that we have the audience there, and also have someone in production as well that is yet to be confirmed. So basically with the masterclass, we hope that the industry leaders will impact their knowledge, their experience on the students, so that they know, okay, if this is the path that I want to take, this is what I need to do to get there. So definitely having that inspiration aspect of it, yeah.
I always thank people mm-hmm. That are making impact in society, because yeah. it's an extra layer to your day-to-day living. You're already a mother, you're already yeah. a wife, you're already yeah. got, you know, running other businesses.
Yeah.
So it's more of a thank you for those who are watching it, mm-hmm. Because it takes a lot to gather these and bring together yeah. these events.
Yeah.
These masterclasses, can anybody attend?
Yes, so it's since we're taking it on campus, it's going to be for the campus audience. But if we will advertise it, so if you feel like it's something that you want to attend, you can attend. But most of the programs, we film it and put it on our YouTube page.
Okay,
so
nice.
You're able to later consume the content and then make sure, like, find the inspiration out of that.
Nice.
Yeah.
There is an important message though.
Mm-hmm.
We've got work to do, and normally they call that the call to action.
Yeah.
And we've got 10 years to make it happen.
Yeah.
I'll let you tell those at home what we need to do by 2035.
By 2035, we hope to reach at least 5,000 girls in the rural communities by providing them with sanitary pad products. We also hope to cut down the number of school absenteeism with the girls to at least 10%. Join us now to end period poverty in your own little way if you can buy a sanitary pad product for a girl in your neighborhood.
Thank you, Tracy, for being brave.
Thank you so much, Bianca, for taking the time out today.